I would like to first apologize to my Marathi friends for speaking in Malayalam, because I think I would rather introduce today's topic to mostly the students who are assembled here. മലയാളികളെ സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം മറാഠി സാഹിത്യം എനിക്ക് തോന്നുന്നു നമുക്ക് ബംഗാളി സാഹിത്യത്തോളം പരിചിതമായ ഒരു സാഹിത്യമല്ല എന്ന്. കാരണം വളരെ കുറച്ച് കൃതികളെ മറാഠിയിൽ നിന്ന് ഒരുപക്ഷെ മലയാളത്തിൽ പരിഭാഷപ്പെടുത്തപ്പെട്ടിട്ടുള്ളൂ. എൻ്റെ തലമുറ ഒരുപക്ഷെ നിങ്ങളുടെ തലമുറയുമൊക്കെ ആദ്യമായി മറാഠി സാഹിത്യത്തെ അറിയുന്നത് വി എസ് ഖാണ്ഡേക്കറുടെ യയാതി എന്ന നോവലിലൂടെയായിരിക്കും. അത് ഒരു കാലത്ത് മാതൃഭൂമിയിൽ പരമ്പരയായി പ്രസിദ്ധപ്പെടുത്തുകയും പിന്നീട് അനേകം പതിപ്പുകൾ ഇറങ്ങുകയും ചെയ്ത ഒരു പുസ്തകമാണ് ഖാണ്ഡേക്കറുടെ യയാതി. അതോടൊപ്പം തന്നെ എൻ്റെ വ്യക്തിജീവിതത്തെ സംബന്ധിച്ചിടത്തോളം ഈ മറാഠിയിലെ ഭക്തികവികളുമായി നാമദേവനും തുക്കാറാമും ചൊക്കാമേളയും കർമ്മമേളയും ഒക്കെ ഉൾപ്പെട്ട ഭക്തി കവിതയുമായുള്ള ഒരു പരിചയം, സമഗ്രമായ പരിചയം നേടാനുള്ള ഒരു ശ്രമം ഞാൻ നടത്തുകയുണ്ടായി. പക്ഷെ പിന്നീട് മറാഠി സാഹിത്യം കൂടുതലായി മലയാളത്തിൽ അറിയപ്പെടാൻ ആരംഭിക്കുന്നത് മറാഠി ദളിത് സാഹിത്യത്തിൻ്റെ ഉയർച്ചയോടുകൂടിയാണ്. എനിക്ക് ഓർമ്മയുണ്ട് 1971 തോന്നുന്നു ആദ്യമായി മറാഠി ദളിത് സാഹിത്യത്തെ മലയാളത്തിൽ അവതരിപ്പിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് ഒരുപാട് പരിഭാഷകൾ ഞാൻ ആ കാലത്ത് ചെയ്യുകയുണ്ടായി. നാംദേവ് ടസാൽ, രാജാധാലെ, അരുൺ കാംബ്ലെ, ഒട്ടേറെ എഴുത്തുകാരുടെ കവിതകളും കുറേയേറെ കഥകളും പരിഭാഷപ്പെടുത്തി. പിന്നീട് മലയാളത്തിൽ ശരൺകുമാർ ലിംബാലെ ഉൾപ്പെടെയുള്ള ചില ദളിത് സാഹിത്യകാരന്മാരുടെ ആത്മകഥകളും നോവലുകളും പരിഭാഷകളായി വന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഈ രീതിയിലുള്ളൊരു ഏകദേശ പരിചയം മാത്രമാണ് നമുക്ക് മറാഠി സാഹിത്യവുമായിട്ടുള്ളത്. എന്നാൽ ഇവിടെ നാം പല സെഷനുകളിലായി മറാഠി സാഹിത്യത്തിൻ്റെ വിവിധ മുഖങ്ങളെ പരിചയപ്പെടാൻ പോവുകയാണ്. So to begin with Dr. Chandrakant Patil, who is one of the finest living scholars of Marathi literature, he will introduce Marathi literature in general. We have special sessions on Marathi poetry, fiction and other genres. There is also a session where two major Marathi playwrights are talking to each other. Chandrakant will give you an idea, a general idea about Marathi literature, its background and its evolution. He will speak for about 30 minutes or so, and then you can have put questions to him, because the whole session is for 45 minutes and already we have taken a little more than two minutes, so you will have about 10, 12 or even 15 minutes for questions and answers about to clear your doubts about Marathi literature. What is happening in Marathi literature today, and something about it, the history and the evolution of Marathi literature. I invite my very old friend and fellow writer Chandrakant Patil to speak about Marathi literature in general, putting it in context.
Thank you, Sachidanandanji. I am honored by being invited here to speak on Marathi, a general talk on the Marathi literature as a sort of a history and a contemporary literature. Let me tell you that there are independent sessions on fiction and one session on poetry. A poetry reading from Marathi and one session on Dalit literature in Marathi, because that seems to be the contribution to the Indian literature. To begin with, let me tell you about something of the Marathi language itself. It is believed that the Marathi language is 2000 years old. The first, the great verse book which was written in Maharashtri Prakrut was Gatha Saptasai, which has been translated into English as Gatha Saptashati. That seems to be one of the finest earlier collection of poetry written during 600 or 700 years, and the verses collected together by King Satavahana. But in fact, the real Marathi literature, to which has a certain significance in most of the Indian languages, is from medieval period, that is 12th century. We started the history of Marathi literature with the revolt itself, the literature of revolt. This revolt was against the caste system, against the inequalities regarding the social and gender inequalities. It was against the language itself, because the earlier language that was to be used was Sanskrit. And we started with the revolt against this language, various social aspects, and the entire history of the medieval period starts, as far as the prose is concerned, it starts from a great founder of a sect, Sri Chakradhar Swami, in 13th century. Chakradhar Swami started Mahanubhav sect, and this gave an excellent prose of Marathi, which is still taken to be an ideal version, an ideal type of the prose writing. The Mahanubhav sect, which started writing prose, and the Leela Charitra is one of the fundamental book of this particular sect, tells about the travels of Sri Chakradhar Swami going through various villages, etc. As far as the poetry is concerned, although it is stated that Mukunda Raja, a poet from Ambazogai, started the Marathi verse, but the real starting point is believed to be Jnaneshwar, Saint Jnaneshwaras, Jnaneshwari. It is totally a philosophical as well as an excellent poetic version of the philosophy of the Warkari Sampradaya, a new sect which was established earlier. Saint Jnaneshwar is remembered today and will be remembered always because he started writing in Marathi as against the classical Sanskrit language. So this was, for the first time, a revolt against the classical Sanskrit language. The second thing is, from Jnaneshwar begins a sect which is still dominant today, and it is known as Warkari Sampradaya or Bhakti Sampradaya. We find that there is a continuous tradition from the 12th or 13th century up to even today. The Warkari or Bhakti Sampradaya is actually an extension of the Bhakti Sampradaya, which has already originated in southern India, in Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, etc. Warkaris or Bhakti Sampradaya produce four major saints, but the major concern of these saints was restricted to the social reformation. Number one is Saint Jnaneshwar. The contemporary of Jnaneshwar is another great saint from the same area, Saint Namdev. And it is Namdev who spread Warkari Sampradaya or this sect all over the India. It is not surprising that Namdev, who traveled up to Punjab, many of his verses have been included in the Guru Nanak's Guru Bani. And we find that Namdev was really the one who was propagating this particular sect, but he was also a revolting saint against the social disorder, inequalities, etc. After that, we come to the third saint, Saint Eknath. He was from the 16th century. Saint Eknath was also propagating the same thing, and we remember Eknath for using a number of various strategies to propagate the revolt against the inequalities. It is believed that Saint Eknath is a founder of the modern theater or the theatrical aspects of the entire literature in Marathi. The fourth one, and perhaps the one who is known in all over the India as one of the biggest saints that Marathi has produced, is Saint Tukaram or Sant Tukaram. 17th century saint Sant Tukaram is believed to be a climax of the verse or the tradition of the Varkari Sampradaya, and Tukaram propagated the inequalities, social disorder, and he was an ardent critic of the social injustice. But really, the Tukaram also tried to liberate the life of the human beings, and he was also a philosopher come poet, but his social inequality and critique or the revolt against the social inequalities was projected in 20th century, and most of the poets, our poets, like contemporary poets like Arun Kolhatkar and Dilip Chitre and Nemade and many others, it's believed to be the rediscovery of Tukaram's Abhangas, Tukaram's verses, by these major poets. So Tukaram is an idol of most of the poets as well as the Varkaris. Varkaris means the followers of that particular sect of the Varkari Sampradaya. Then we come to the 19th century. The 18th century and 19th century, they evolved typical Marathi genres. One of them in prose is Bakhar Wangmay, which is a documentation of the various kings and documentation of the social order which was established in, which was there prevalent in the 19th century and 18th century. That was a period of Shahirs who contributed poetry as well as the philosophy merged together, but this philosophy was a religious philosophy. Now we come to the 20th century, and as we find it in 20th century in prose, one of the greatest novelists which is to be remembered historically in Marathi is Hari Narayan Apte. Hari Narayan Apte wrote novels of social documentation such as Me or Myself or I, as well as But Who Cares, which is Pan Lakshat Kondgeto, that is But Who Cares, that has been translated into English. So we find that as far as the novels of Hari Narayan Apte are concerned, who is the who is, as far as the modern literature or 20th century fiction is concerned, who is at the top of this? Thank you. In prose as well as in poetry, we have a tradition of social reforming. And perhaps Maharashtra is the only state where we find a continuous tradition of social reformation right from the 12th century to the 21st century. It's unrestricted, a continuous, incessant tradition of the social documentation as well as social critique. Naturally, we find that this happened because of the great social thinkers in the 20th century. To name some of the most important social thinkers who were responsible for the social reformation were Lokahitwadi, Gopal Ganesh Agarkar, Tilak, Lokmanya Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Mahatma Phule, and recently, that is mid-20s, Dr. Ambedkar, as well as many others who were basically concerned with the civilization, the change in the civilization, change in the societal structure, as well as they were against the caste system. And the treatment that is given to the women in contemporary world. So Agarkar had a direct disciple. The student of Agarkar was Harinarayan Apte. Harinarayan Apte was greatly influenced by Agarkar. So he wrote very important novels of the social reform, as well as the historical novels also. The entertainment novels for entertainment were also written by Harinarayan Bhakte, but Harinarayan Apte is remembered for the social reformations. The next we come to most of the followers of these, and then we come to 20th century, where a major breakthrough of in the area of novel was by certain writers who had a philosophical bent, and the two fiction writers, important fiction writers, were Sridhar Venkatesh Ketkar, who was a great scholar, and the another was Vaman Malhar Joshi, who was a philosopher. Both of them wrote a number of novels, as well as they also wrote the non-fiction, and that is concerned with the social reformation as well as the social philosophy. After that, a major breakthrough was observed in case of, in 1940s, a generation educated in British Empire, particularly in England, and the leading person of that, who is actually remembered for his great breakthrough in the poetry, is Bal Sitaram Murdekar. Murdekar wrote three novels. These three novels were influenced by the stream of consciousness. And it was altogether unknown for Marathi readers. It's something like a shocking treatment given to the Marathi readers through his novels. Murdekar, of course, is remembered for his poetry, and he is known as one of the important poets after the Keshav Sood. After that, we have a generation of the short story writers. The short story is again a form which continued from the beginning of the 20th century. And in 40s, a new trend in the short story in Marathi was observed by four writers like Gangadhar Galgir, Arvinda Gokhale, Pubha Bhave, and Venkatesh Madgulkar. This was a generation of the 40s and 50s, and they continue to write up to the 2000. After this, the short story, we do not have a major short story writer, but again, once we find that by the end of this, or in the last quarter of the 20th century, we had a great short story writer Baburao Bagul, who belonged to Dalit society, and he was a powerful messenger to convey the agonies and sufferings of Dalit for the first time. So Baburao Bagul is at the beginning of the most of the Dalit prose writing. Then we come to poetry. Coming back to poetry, again inspired by the social reformation of Agarkar and others, Lokahitwadi and Agarkar, the first major poet is believed to be Keshav Sut. Keshav Sut was a poet. On one side, he was deeply influenced by the British ideology of liberalism, individualism, as well as the justice to most of these social strata. On the other side, we find that he was a romantic poet who was educated by the generation of the Victorian and Edwardian poetry, etc. So Keshav Sut is remembered today for his poetry of social reformation. After Keshav Sut, there were a number of movements that occurred. But the most important thing, most important poet who revolutionized the entire poetry is Basi Merdekar. I had given a reference of Merdekar in case of fiction. He wrote fiction as well as the theories. He was also a theorist, and Arts and Man is one of the books that influenced the later writers. Merdekar revolted against the domesticity that was a family, and the entire poetry earlier was getting devolved against the family system, etc., the traditions, the love, romanticism, etc. Merdekar was, of course, deeply influenced by the poetry of Eliot, T.S. Eliot, and Auden. He was also familiar with the European literature because he has written one very excellent essay on the great playwright of Europe. Merdekar is one of the persons who inspired the later poets like Vinda Karandikar. Vinda Karandikar has a super blend of social, individual, political, and all types of the formalist poetry. Then comes some of the minor poets like Mangesh Padgaonkar and Vasant Bapat. But a major change or a shift in paradigm occurred in 1960s, where a new generation, inspired by most of the European writers, European poets, European thinkers, emerged, and leading poets in those were Dilip Purushottam Chitre, Arun Kolatkar, and the generation that is termed as the little magazine poetry. So that is how it occurred in case of the poetry. We have some very eminent poets who are going to read their poetry in the next session, later sessions. And one of the major fiction writer is Shyam Manohar, who is sitting here. The poets like Anuradha Patil and Sridhar Nandedkar from also Marathi literature, we'll see, or you have to a chance to witness how the literature has gone from the traditional to the absolutely new forefront. Leaving aside this mainstream literature, we come to another alternative stream of literature, and that is termed as Dalit literature. Although Baburao Bagul is one of the major short story writers, but the short story of Dalit did not flourish, and it was restricted to the few writers like Vaman Howal and Kesho Mishram and some others. What major change that occurred in case of Dalit literature is the writings which were on the margins, the writings which were considered to be a marginal writing, became the center stage after the powerful writing of Dalits. But the genre that is adopted by most of the Dalit writers is autobiography. And Satchidanandan has given a reference to that. The most important autobiographies which were written earlier by Lakshman Mane, Lakshman Gaikwad, Daya Pawar, whose daughter is one of the important poetess of contemporary literature, and she would be coming and reading her poems in the next session. And we have seen that in case of these autobiographies, the women autobiography, because we consider, Dalits have considered that women are doubly marginalized, as women as well as Dalit. So the best of the autobiographies written by women have been translated into most of the Indian languages, and that has been treated as one of the excellent introduction to the Indian literature overall. These are some of the things. As far as the criticism is concerned, we had great critics like G.T. Deshpande, who introduced the medieval Sanskrit literature, and some of the critics of the earlier generation are W.L. Kulkarni and R.S. Jog, etc. It is quite important that some of the poets or writers themselves became important critics, such as Dilip Chitre and Nemade and others. By saying this, we are going to be in greater details with the fiction and poetry and Dalit literature, etc. This was just an overview of the Marathi literature. And as far as the success of the Marathi literature, the positive sides of the Marathi literature of the particular genre, as well as the negative points of these, can be just discussed in the later independent sessions. I stop it here, and I request you, if you have certain questions, let us have some discussion. That would be better for the understanding of the Marathi literature, etc. I stop it here. Thank you very much.
So you have an idea, at least an outline of 1,000 years, in fact, of Marathi literature, which is very hard to really sum up. But I think Chandrakant has done justice to the history of Marathi literature within the time limit that he was given. Now you are free to, you have about 10 minutes to ask questions, 10-12 minutes to clear your doubts about the evolution of Marathi literature or its different genres or different ages. You might know that perhaps modern poetry in India, I would say, begins with B.S. Marthekar of Marathi. It is much later that it traveled to Bengali and Malayalam and several other languages, because we began to have what is generally called modern literature in the 1960s. But already in the late 40s, Marathi had developed a modern sensibility in poetry and fiction. So I think, especially for students of comparative literature, it would be a great idea to make a kind of comparison between the different periods when these new movements entered the two languages, and how in different ways they developed. Like, again, if you look at ദളിത് ലിറ്ററേച്ചർ ഇൻ മറാഠി, ദളിത് ലിറ്ററേച്ചർ ഇൻ ഇന്ത്യ. മറാഠി വാസ് ദ പൈനിയർ. മറാഠി ലെഡ് ദളിത് ലിറ്ററേച്ചർ വിത്ത് ദി അറൈവൽ ഓഫ് എ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് പോയറ്റ്സ് ആൻഡ് ഓട്ടോബയോഗ്രഫേഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് ഫിക്ഷൻ റൈറ്റേഴ്സ്. സം ഓഫ് ദ നെയിംസ് ഹാവ് ഓൾറെഡി ബീൻ മെൻഷൻഡ്, യു നോ, റൈറ്റ് ഫ്രം Namdev Tasal to some of the poets who are here, to various novelists like Lakshman Mane and Lakshman Gaikwad and Sharan Kumar Limbale. So we have a very rich body of Dalit literature in India, perhaps the richest body of Dalit literature in India you can find in Marathi. And it was from there that then it spread to Gujarati, and then it began to spread to other languages like Hindi, and then to the South Indian languages. And now in Malayalam also we speak of a body of Dalit literature which actually has only some 10 years, it's almost a decade long, even though now we are tracing that history back to Saraswati Vijayam of the 19th century, etc. But if you look at modern Dalit literature, the history of modern Dalit literature in Malayalam is not that long. So it would be interesting to make some comparisons, and maybe you have some questions to ask, clarifications and questions to ask to Chandrakant, who will be happy to respond to you. Yeah.
ഇനി നിങ്ങളിൽ നിന്നുള്ള ചോദ്യങ്ങളെ പ്രതീക്ഷിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുകയാണ് അവർ. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് പല മറുപടിയും പ്രതീക്ഷിക്കണമെങ്കിൽ നിങ്ങൾ ചോദിക്കണം. 10 മിനിറ്റാണ് സമയം അനുവദിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത്. കഴിയുന്നതും വേഗം ആ സെഷൻ തീർക്കുക.
ചന്ദ്രകാന്ത്, ഐ ലിസൺ ടു മോസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി പാർട്ട് ഓഫ് യുവർ സ്പീച്ച്. ഇറ്റ്സ് എ പെർഫെക്റ്റ് ഓവർവ്യൂ of Marathi literature so far. In fact, languages like ours, for us Marathi literature has been very inspiring, and always Marathi literature is looked upon as a progressive writing. Present day situation, in the present day situation, our writers, the present day writers, express themselves as freely as before? Just a passing question. Particularly the younger generation, I find they are somehow subdued. What is your opinion about it?
What I have understood is the earlier generation was more open and frank and was expressing their views quite openly and without any kind of a fear. What is the situation with the younger generation? I mean, there are younger poets who are concerned with the present socio-political cultural situations. But I think they are more particular about the cultural situations, social inequalities, rather than the political structure. And let me make a statement here that comparison of the other literatures, particularly I see the literatures in Hindi and Malayalam and Bengali, the political awareness is at low in case of the younger generation. They are concerned with something which is more about the cultural scenes today and not the political scenes. In that case, I agree with you that the younger generation is trailing behind as far as this particular concern is expressed in their poetry. But it is also seen that they are not having any devices for other artistic structures. The generation that we find here, as far as the present conditions are there, their poetry is again we find that for an example, we had a great upsurge as far as the 1960s poetry as well as Dalit poetry was concerned. But the situation, as we'll see, that well, that will be discussed in the Dalit literature, but we don't find any major poet or any significant poet in Dalit literature after Namdev Desal. There were some poets like Arun Kale, or a tribal poet like Bhujang Meshram, but that that energy, that force is not seen with the younger generation.
Anybody from this side?
So we are all familiar with the Maratha, you know, empire. So has there been any influence of this Maratha empire on Maratha literature? Any great influence?
Yeah. As far as the history is concerned, the Maratha empire is Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj empire. After that, we find that the literature of that kind is in case of the prose writing, as I told earlier, Bakhar literature or the historical documentation flourished very well. That was a contribution to the prose writing as far as the Maratha Empire is concerned. Again, as the major concern of the Marathi literature has remained to be the social revolt, that was also seen to some extent by the Saint poets, because Saint Tukaram is contemporary and he was one of the great witnesses of that Maratha empire. So again, we find that the only thing that occurred is about the social injustice, nothing else, nothing more than that.
Now it's time to conclude this session. Actually, we have no time.
Since we have a few minutes left, Chandrakant, we find the Marathi cinema has developed to a great extent. It's more vocal. Am I audible?
Yeah.
So is it that the creative mind, Marathi mind, is shifting focus on cinema, the visual media? Because I find presently the films that are made in Marathi are very, very creative. Once it was the prerogative of Malayalam cinema, and today I find Marathi cinema is as much dominating as any other. Is Marathi writer deviating from written media to the visual media?
In spite of whatever your observation is, we don't find any major film in younger generation. They are just concerned with the issues that are not the fundamental or the basic issue. They are just the superficial issues like the social inequalities, etc. We lack the directors who gave us a great insight, like Satyajit Ray or Ritvik Ghatak or Mrunal Sen or Arvindan or some of the film directors from the South. But the younger generation seems to be more important simply because of the proliferation of the media. Because these films, well, I may be wrong in that case, but my particular thing is, my opinion is, there is no very prominent Marathi film writer as well as, and the writers are not going or not getting shifted to that. There are opportunities, the new opportunities, and there are schools like everywhere you find the, as Satish Alekar would let you know in his thing, the availability is there, opportunities are there. So everybody wants to make a film, and maybe some films click here and there, but the success of the film is more because of the media and not because of the content and the techniques of the films. That's my opinion. It may be quite different. But the positive answer is no intelligent writer is shifting from literature to film.
No, what about a film like The Court, which has become extremely popular, including in Kerala, and we have had long discussions on a film like The Court.
So there are films like that, a few films that can be stated here, that can be stated here and there. But what is the success of that film in Marathi? We do not have a major success about that. As far as the discussions are there, I can quote another example of a film by Nagaraj. That film is a very popular film, and there is a great discussion about that. But it is again in the same tradition of the social inequalities and nothing more than that. So about popular films and about the films which have been appreciated by media and others, we do not have some major contribution.
I think we should conclude, but I have just another question to ask. Like in Malayalam, a lot of young poets are now taking to writing film lyrics, and they are really good poets. I mean, not that they are bad poets, but some of the finest poets are also taking to writing for the film, songs for the film. Is there such a trend in Marathi?
Yeah, the poets and the writers who want to try their hand in this, they are there. But we do not find a poet like Balachandran Chullikad, who has been shifted to the films and all that. No such major poet has been involved in the filmmaking and all that.
Thank you. I think it's time for the next session. Thank you very much, Chandrakant, and I thank all of you. You can remain here for the next session, or it's up to you to make